Honorable Mongono to move that the bill be now read a second time.
Honorable Speaker, honorable members, my name is Honorable Mohammed Tahir Mongono. I represent Marke Mongono Ngenze Federal Constituency of Borno State. I move that a bill for an act to make provisions for offences relating to terrorism prohibit the financing of terrorism and consolidate all acts relating to terrorism and a bill for an act
Honorable Soba, please.
The Terrorism Honorable Act of 2011 for the purpose of applying stringent prison terms for offences of terrorism and remove the ambiguities in the act and for other related matters be read the second time. I so move.
Honorable Babakaita, you are a call.
Katsina State. Arise to second.
Honorable Mongono, please lead the debate.
Honorable Speaker, refreshing the memory of this August Assembly, human memory being momentary, I wish to inform this House that this hallowed Assembly, in its wisdom, passed the Terrorism Act 2011 and at the same time passed the Terrorism Amendment Act of 2013 into law for the purpose of fighting the scourge of terrorism that has now bedeviled Nigeria and more particularly the northeastern part of the country. And terrorism and terrorist activities being offenses that are fluid in nature and are evolving and being multifaceted in nature, they are dynamic. And as Udo Udoma, I think of blessed memory, said in the course of his judgment in the Supreme Court that our laws and statute books are supposed to be like organic documents or living things that will change in accordance with the realities of the society. And Parliament being an arm of government that is vested with this sacred duty of amending our laws to reflect the existing realities in the society, it behoves on this hallowed chamber to amend the Terrorism Act of 2011 and indeed the Terrorism Amendment Act of 2013 to bring it in tandem with the existing reality of fighting the scourge of terrorism in this country, especially against the backdrop of the obvious lacuna that was observed, that was not carried or was not adequately addressed in the previous acts. Mr. Speaker, honorable members, as I earlier said, terrorism being an offense that is multifaceted in nature, an offense that is evolving in nature, and in our criminal jurisprudence, for an action or for an act to constitute a criminal offense, it must be codified. So there is a need for us to codify actions that terrorists are now perpetrating that are hitherto not captured in the previous act. For example, the issue of relating to international terrorism funds, seizure of terrorist cash and property, and also charities that are linked to terrorist activities, then because terrorism is a worldwide phenomenon that cut across the nooks and crannies of the globe, there is need for
Honorable Obonta, Obonta, please sit down and keep quiet.
Of the jurisdiction of this country and terrorists within the jurisdiction of this country to other countries that hitherto has not been captured by the previous
please
act. So Mr. Speaker, foreign members, what this bill essentially seeks to do is for the purpose of reference when it comes to adjudication that there is need for these two initial bills to be refilled, and then offenses that were hitherto not captured in the previous act to be captured, and then come up with a single act that deals with terrorism for the ease of reference and for ease of adjudication in our court. So that is essentially what this bill seeks to do, and I urge my colleagues to borrow the word of Honorable Osai Osai to support the second reading of this bill with the speed of light. Thank you.
Honorable Keita. Thank you. The motion say aye. Those against it say nay. The ayes have it. Clerk is invited to read the long title.
To make provisions for offenses relating to terrorism, prohibit the financing of terrorism, and consolidate all acts relating to terrorism, and a bill for now to amend the Terrorism Act of 2011 for the purpose of applying student prison terms for offenses of terrorism and remove the ambiguities in the act and for other related matters. Second reading.
Bill is referred to the Committee on National Security and Intelligence. Second order of the day, Honorable